Now let's talk about what the two forms of Ampere's law means. The point form, over here on the right, is showing us that if I have a surface current density, this is like amps per meter squared, that is going to cause a magnetic field that is curling, this is the curl, that's curling around it. So the curl means put your thumb in the direction of the current density that you see, and your fingers will curl around it like the magnetic field that's produced at that single point by that little bit of current density. If I look at the integral form of Ampere's law, that's very similar. That's saying, suppose that I have a current like this I can do a closed contour. There's my closed contour, also using the right-hand rule to define the direction, and that's going to tell me that my magnetic field is going around the current in this contour. Again, put your thumb in the direction of the current, and your fingers on your right hand will follow in the direction of the magnetic field. Here are the steps to performing Ampere's law in integral form. First, be sure that your current is symmetric. This means that there's no variation in phi. H must be equal in magnitude every place on your Gaussian surface. If it isn't, go back and use the Biot-Savart law. Then choose a Gaussian contour, think of a belt, that's able to wrap around all the current that you are interested in. So, for instance, if I have a current in this direction, I'm just going to put a circular belt like this in order to find the magnetic field. The surface that we'll be integrating on the right-hand side is inside that belt. So first, do the integral on the left-hand side. For any given geometry, such as cylindrical, that integral is always going to be the same. Then, do the integral on the right-hand side in order to find the current that's passing through the closed contour or the belt that you picked up. One good way to think about it is using your fingers to grab all of the current. And that's what you're going to be integrating on the right-hand side. Finally, equate the left-hand side to the right-hand side in order to solve for H. And remember that B is equal to mu H. So if you know the material properties mu, you'll be able to find the magnetic flux density B. There are three possible forms of current that we're interested in. One is just a straight line current, something like I is 7 amps in the z direction. Another one is current flowing on a surface, such as on the inner conductor of a coax. Since we know that the coax is metal, whether it is hollow or not, the current is going to be flowing all on the outside, and it's going to be uniformly distributed. So again, we can just say that I is 7 amps, and it's flowing in the z direction on the outside of the cylinder. In both of these cases, when we put our closed contour around it, is just going to be a circular contour like this. In the case of the coax, we might put our closed contour on the inside, where we would find that no current was picked up, and therefore the magnetic field was zero, or we might put our closed contour on the outside like this, and in that case, the two problems, the line current or the current flowing on the surface, would be identical. Their solution would give us exactly the same result. And finally, we might have a current such as on a plasma, a beam of plasma, where the current distribution is not necessarily uniformly distributed. Still, we will have no variation in phi, but we could have R variation. Let me make that a small r. We could have R variation instead. That means that if I looked at this at the tip of this plasma beam, the current might be very dense in the center and weaker as I move to the outside, or it might be very dense on the outside and weaker as I moved into the center. In this case, when I make my Gaussian contour, such as on the inside, I literally need to pick up how much of this current is on the inside of the contour, and I ignore all of the current that's on the outside. The reason that I do that is because the current on the outside is creating no magnetic field around this particular contour.